My name is Abby Snodgrass, and I'm a senior at Hillsboro High School.
My first impression of Abby when I met her was that she was very modest. She wasn't on cloud nine, she was just very matter of fact. This is what I did, this is what the story was.
Abby is a great student. She's very respectful, she's very bright. She's always here, she's always participating in the lesson. Just an all around really good kid.
She didn't want any of the accolades that she received for doing this. It was just part of a normal day. Just go to Walmart and do CPR on an infant. You know, like anybody can do this.
I just went to Walmart to just go pick up a few things that I needed. I just got paid and I went into the dressing room to just try on a few things, you know. As I was coming out of the dressing room, I heard over the associate's radio, there's some kind of code in electronics, someone stopped breathing and they don't have a pulse. And I just grabbed my stuff and I ran over to electronics. When I got there, I expected it to be like an elderly person or an adult, maybe that had some kind of emergency like that. I was not expecting a baby, and when I got there, it surprised me so much that it was a baby. There was a Walmart associate sitting on the ground holding the baby, and then the mom was sitting on the ground next to them. But there was a lot of adults and with carts and their stuff just standing in a big circle around them, just wondering what's going on, not really knowing what to do. I asked the Walmart associate, I was like, does anyone know CPR? And she goes, I do. And I was like, but she hands me the baby and says, you do it. I just, kind of what I learned in Ms. Husky's class kind of kicked in, and I was like, okay, put the baby on my forearm facing me and just do the 5 chest compressions with my two fingers. And then I'd flip her around and do the 5 back blows on her back. I did that about probably 3 times. So I did the 5 chest compressions, then flipped her on her stomach and did the 5 back blows about 2 or 3 times. And then when I flipped her back onto her back, she just goes and takes like a short breath in. And I was like, oh, it worked. The baby took the breath. I felt the biggest sigh. It was the biggest relief I've ever felt in my life. And I just held her for a moment and waited for the paramedics to get there. Then I handed her to the Walmart associate. And then I went and sat down with the mother to try to comfort her a little bit. After I sat down and talked with the mom for a second, the paramedics came and everyone kind of left and dispersed. So there was a few people that stopped me and said, you did good. Thank you so much. I'm just really proud of you, and everyone just went back about their business. So I definitely think my training kicked in and not my emotion, because I would have been scared to death and I have no idea why I wasn't, because I should have been. The CPR training helped me save the baby's life.
I started the program because I knew that CPR made a difference in a life of a young girl, personally. And I know that if more people do know CPR, they're going to be saving lives and people are going to live. It does make a difference.
We teach CPR in our health classes. It's part of the health curriculum, so all of our students here will get CPR training at Hillsboro High School.
I thought the CPR class was going to be fun. Like, I was pretty excited for it.
We bring in paramedics from the local ambulance district, and they work one-on-one with our kids. They bring in dummies and they teach them the hands-only method as well as other methods. I typically walk around as well as some other assistants, and we make sure the kids are doing it correctly. We help them position their hands because sometimes they'll slip too far forward or backwards. We help them keep count as far as beats per minute and just answer any general questions that they have.
I think high school is the perfect time for students to learn CPR, for young adults to learn CPR. They are young adults, they're making life decisions, and this is the decision that can make a difference in their life or the life of someone that they know or a complete stranger.
I never thought that I would actually use the CPR that I learned in class, because that's just not something you run across every day, is something like that would happen.
For me as a teacher, it takes very little time to include CPR in the health curriculum. Very few resources are needed, And in just 30 minutes of teaching hands-only CPR, it can have a huge impact on that student's life, and they could be using that in a real-life situation to save someone else's life in the future.
I would tell schools that are on the fence that are trying to start programs that there's lots of resources out there available to them. They can look at their ambulance districts, they can look at the fire departments, they can call the American Heart Association, that the resources don't have to cost money, that the difference is the lives that can be saved through learning CPR.
It's important that we learn CPR in the schools. You never know when you're going to come across a situation that you're going to need to use what you've learned, and it's good to have that knowledge when the situation arises.
I encourage parents to look at their students' curriculum at their schools, and if their schools are not offering CPR, then they need to contact their state legislatures. The goal is to get students to learn CPR statewide in all schools.
In all reality, out of 4 years of high school, it's 30 minutes that could save a life.
You just never know when you're going to be called upon to do those, when a situation's going to arise that you're the only one that can potentially save that person's life.